These are the buildings which we pass every day. Some we call home, some work. They're the threads which woven together create the urban fabric of our city. But as time ushers in inevitable decay, which ones will live, which will die? Which buildings will be preserved to define Fort Worth? Montgomery Ward Retail Store and Warehouse is located just across the Trinity River from downtown Fort Worth. Constructed in 1928, the overall design of the warehouse is Mission Revival. In early 2001, Montgomery Ward went out of business, closing the store and leaving the property vacant. Since then, however, it has become an emblem for adaptive reuse, now thriving with retail on the ground floor and condos up above. It is the anchor of the West 7th Street development. The Ball Edelman McFarland House is located at 1110 Penn Street. Constructed in 1899, this large Victorian home originally belonged to a cattle baron family. It is now owned by Historic Fort Worth and is where their office is located. Texas and Pacific Railway Terminal is located on the south side of downtown Fort Worth and was constructed in 1931 in the zigzag modern style of Art Deco. The U.S. Post Office is situated in between the railway terminal and the warehouse to the west, and departs from style of Art Deco and is constructed in the Beaux Arts and Classical styling. The railroad, which spurred the development of this complex, is still in operation today and runs parallel with I-30. These buildings are being adapted today into lofts and office spaces. Texas is famous for its county courthouses, and the Tarrant County Courthouse is one of the grandest of them all. Constructed in 1895 of pink Texas granite, this enduring structure is still fully operational today. Other civic buildings in Fort Worth include the U.S. Courthouse, which was constructed in 1933. Tieran Building, located 1000 Houston, was constructed in 1907 and modeled after the Flatiron Building in New York. It was one of the first steel frame buildings in Fort Worth and one of the tallest commercial buildings in North Texas in the early 1900s. St. Andrew's Episcopal Church at 901 Lamar. This Gothic Revival church is another of the many Fort Worth buildings designed by Sam Cornett and Stotts. The First United Methodist Church was constructed in 1930, another Gothic Revival church, which was built with care and still provides a place of worship for people today. St. Patrick Cathedral. Once a tall spire standing in downtown Fort Worth, is now dwarfed by the Omni Hotel and the AT&T building. The chapel, the rectory, and the school make up the elements of the oldest continuously used church building in Fort Worth, and they are expanding. The buildings we have seen have found their place in the hearts and souls of Fort Worthians, and they have been placed on the historic preservation list. As these buildings endure, so will the memory of those who made them, those who sacrificed to make this city. These buildings stand in memory of those who made Fort Worth.